Hi everyone, now we are going to discuss about microorganisms. Already we have started about how microorganisms are useful to us, what are the various types of microorganisms is there, okay, the advantages of microorganisms, we learned about the different structures of microorganisms. Now we are going to discuss about harmful microorganisms, how microorganisms are harmful to us. Harmful to the human beings, harmful to the living organisms. That means most of the microorganisms are useful to us. Okay, in preparation of antibiotic, preparation of medicine, preparation of what? Food items, preparation of what? Even manure, manure means what? Fertilizers, everything is what? In everywhere, the microorganism, different various types of microorganisms are useful. For preparation of what different types of what antibiotics, manure and medicine and as economically useful food materials and everything. But in all microorganisms are not useful to us, not useful to the living organisms. They are harmful. It's cause of diseases. We are suffered with so many diseases. The cause of disease. One of the cause of disease, the cause of disease means what? Okay, in disease means what? What is the meaning of disease? That means in our body, any organ is not functioning in proper way. If any organ, that is nothing but we can call disease. Physically, for example, in our body, so many various types of systems is there. In that system, any system is not functioning proper way. That is nothing but we can call disease. Uncomfortable. We are not comfort. Uncomfortable situation. Uncomfortable of the body. That is we can call disease. What are the causes of diseases? Generally, if we suffer with disease, one cause is, the main cause is what? Pathogens. Nothing but pathogens means microorganisms are the cause of what? Cause of diseases. Not only microorganisms. Even some diseases are causes of what? Genital problem. That means if our parents are suffer with any disease like cancer, diabetes or hypertension or any other disease, some type of diseases. If maybe we are also suffered with same type of diseases. That is the genetical diseases. But most of the diseases are cause of microorganisms. That means the cause of infection, cause of microorganisms. The microorganisms are parasites. What is the meaning of parasites? Means the parasite means it damages the host. It is living in host body. For example, one microorganism is enter into the body. Enter into my body. That is parasite. Whatever living in my body, whatever microorganism is living in my body, that is you can call parasite. Parasite always damage the host body. Host means what? Who given the shelter to the microorganism? Who given? I am given. For example, I am given shelter to the microorganism. That means I am host. That is parasite. Parasite always living inside the body or outside the body. But host body is required. It is depend upon living body. That is parasites. Most of the microorganisms are parasites. Even when we are discussing about, right now everyone is discussing about COVID-19. That is also nothing but what? Parasite. Okay, anyway, disease causing microorganism we can call pathogens. What we call pathogen, which is cause of microorganism. Disease causing microorganisms, nothing but we can call pathogen. These pathogens cause of diseases, different types of diseases. We are suffered with infections, cold, viral diseases, influenza. Okay, so many diseases. Generally, the causes of diseases are nothing but we can call pathogen. Disease causing microorganisms we can call pathogens. What is pathogen? Pathogen is nothing but disease causing microorganisms. Okay, disease causing
disease causing microorganisms, we can call pathogens. Disease causing germs, we can call pathogen.
These pathogens are enter into the body. How they enter? Mode of transmission. What is the meaning of mode of transmission? Means what? Need to transmit infected person to healthy person. Any disease, even if we are discussing about COVID, that is also communicable disease. Communicable disease. What is the meaning of communicable? Communicable disease. That means what? It communicate healthy infected person, patient to healthy person. Maybe so many modes of transmissions are so many is there. Air, water, contaminated, spoiled food, contaminated water, and what animals, some microorganisms, some insects also cause of what? These are the reason, these are the mode. They transmit the disease from infected person to healthy person. Which are transmitted? Just transmitted by, diseases are transmitted by air, water, food, spoiled food. Food means non-gender food. Okay? Spoiled food, animals, insects. These things we can call carriers. Carriers. What is the meaning of carriers? Means what? They carry. Who carry? These air, water, food, animals, insects, they carry. What they carry? Disease causing microorganism or pathogen from infected person to healthy person. Okay? Generally, we are suffered with so many diseases. Okay? That is in that some diseases are called infection. The infections are cause of what? Infections or diseases cause of what? Pathogen. Pathogen means microorganism. What type of microorganisms causes of infections? Already we learned about microorganisms are five types is there. What are they? Virus, bacteria, fungus, protozoans and algae. Here, the causes of infections, viruses, bacteria, fungus, and also protozoans. Some of the protozoans also cause of diseases. We suffered with what? Some type of diseases causes of what? Viruses, bacteria, and fungus and protozoans also cause of what? Some type of diseases. Whatever we are suffered, whatever plants are suffered, whatever other organisms are suffered. Anyway, that means these disease-causing microorganisms enter into the body. It takes some time for development. Try to understand. For example, we ate some spoiled food. For example, any viruses enter into the body. It takes some time for develop. Already we learnt about the virus. Viruses are connecting link between living and non-living things. When they are in outside the body, they behave like non-living thing. When they enter into the body, behave like living things. When they are entered, for example, if we are discussing about virus, when the viruses are entered into the body, what happened? It starts from reproduce. It starts from dividing. Reproduce and developing in body, inside the body only. So that period we can call incubation period means what? Any microorganism is enter into the body, it takes some time to develop, it takes some time to reproduce, it takes some time to what? Increase, multiplies. That period we can call incubation period. In the incubation, after incubation period, the symptoms means what? Headache, fever, chill fever, cough, sneezing, whatever is there. That whatever symptoms after incubation period it will be showing, it will damage our organs. These microorganisms, whatever microorganism, whatever parasites enter into the body, these microorganisms damage. It damage any cells in our body. For example, COVID, we are discussing about COVID. Actually, these COVID, whatever COVID virus, that affects our lungs, especially in alveolis. In lungs, cells is there, alveoli. These effects, it filled with what? Mucus. Alveoli are filled with what? Mucus. So that what will be happen? The breathing is not occurring proper way. So that it damage our cells. Not only this COVID. And remaining whatever microorganisms is there, these microorganisms damage our body cells. So that we are infected with what? Diseases. Okay, anyway, yeah. Okay, what we have to do if we suffer with diseases? Okay, recently we are discussing about immunity. What is immunity? Disease resistance power. What is disease resistance power? In our body, having some capable to, policemen is there, soldiers is there in our body. If any foreign material or other material enter into the body, these policemen are kills that one. If person to person, this immunity power is different. For example, some person's immunity power is more, some person's immunity power is less. If who are having immunity power is less, automatically they are suffered with what? Various types of diseases. Some diseases are chronic diseases, AIDS, chronic disease. Chronic disease means they need to, they are suffered from that disease for lifelong, they are suffered with disease. Diabetes, diabetes is not suffered with what? Cause of microorganism. That is what? Inherited or food, not proper what? Lifestyle. Okay, anyway, okay, no need. Okay, here microorganisms, that mean even human beings, even plants, even animals, all animals also suffered with what? Various type of diseases, the cause of what? Microorganisms. Here, okay, some examples given. Some of the examples of microorganisms which are harmful, which are effects to the human beings. Okay, which are effects to the human beings. Some microorganisms which affect to the human beings. That means some common human diseases. What we are discussing? Microorganism, friends and okay. Some common human diseases caused by microorganism. This is causing microorganism, what we call pathogens. Okay, here given some examples of whatever we are suffered with various types of diseases nowadays. So that given some examples only. One example is tuberculosis. Tuberculosis. What is this? This is disease name. What is that disease name? Tuberculosis. The cause of disease causing microorganism or causative microorganism of tuberculosis. Causative microorganism of tuberculosis is what? Bacteria. Bacteria is cause of tuberculosis. Generally, which bacteria is cause of tuberculosis? Tuberculosis is cause of what? Mycobacteria tubercoli. Tubercoli. This is what? Bacteria name. Okay, that bacteria is cause of what? Tuberculosis. And mode of transmission. What is the meaning of mode of transmission? How diseases are transmitted from infected person or patient to healthy person. How the mediators are required. Carriers, we can call what we call carriers. The carriers are required. For example, generally nowadays we are discussing about COVID, coronavirus, especially how it transmit through with what? Droplets. Through with the droplets, person to person. When we are sneezing, when we are talking, when we are that time what coughing, automatically these droplets are transmit through with air to another person with certain distance. Okay, anyway, here one example given, tuberculosis, causative microorganism, bacteria. Mode of transmission, how it transmit infected person to healthy person through with air.
preventing measures. What is the meaning of preventing measures? What type of precautions we have to take? What we need to do to cure? What type of treatment we have to take when we are suffered with what tuberculosis? What tuberculosis patient need to keep isolation? Isolation of patient. Okay. Nowadays also who are suffered with corona also, they are keeping in isolation in separate room. That isolation means for single, separate. They are keeping in separate room. Why? Because that is a communicable disease. Communicable disease. It within short time, it will be, if it is within short time, it affects other person. So that it is called communicable disease. Okay. What is that one especially for here? Tuberculosis also. Who are suffered with tuberculosis, they are keeping isolation, and vaccination is important. Vaccination need to take precaution. What type of precaution? Vaccination. What is the meaning of vaccination? Antibiotic is different. Vaccination is different. Antibiotic, when we are suffered with any type of disease, we are taking antibiotic. Vaccination means what? Before, we are not suffered with any disease, but before only we are taking some vaccine, some medicine. That medicine, whatever we are not suffered with any disease, but before only we are taking some medicines. That medicines are useful to increase immunity power. Already I am told, resistance power, body resistance power, white blood cells, whatever increase immunity power in our immunology, immunity power in our body. That is the use of vaccination. That's why when we are in childish stage, we are taking polio vaccine, BCG, DPT vaccine, so many vaccines, even hepatitis vaccine recently. Vaccine means what? Before we are taking vaccine. After suffered with any disease, we are taking what? Antibiotics. Okay, try to understand the difference between vaccine and antibiotic. Here, second disease name is measles. Measles is the cause of virus. How it is mode of transmission? Through with air. Same preventing methods, isolation of patients, vaccination. And chickenpox. Chickenpox. In general, in India, in their lifetime, at least all are suffered, at least one time all are suffered with what? Chickenpox. Small rashes if it comes, fever, rashes and... Okay, chickenpox is also cause of what? Causative microorganism is what? Virus only. Okay, how it transmit means what? Air and direct contact. Air. And other one is contact. What is the meaning of contact means what? If you touch that person who are infected with chickenpox, if you touch that person, we are also suffered with chickenpox. If you saw himself, we are also suffered with chickenpox. That is very, within short term, it is what? Communicable disease. Even, mode of transmission, air and direct contact. Contact means touching. Go through nearby that patient. We are also suffered with what? That disease. Next one, polio. Polio virus. That is also virus. Cause of polio also cause of virus. Air and water. That is also mode of transmission. Air and water. Isolation of patient. Isolation and vaccination are the preventing methods. Next, cholera. This cholera, generally in rainy season, and most of the children or elders also suffered with what? Cholera. Actually, this cholera, who are drinking what, especially contaminated food, contaminated water and spoiled food, they are suffered with cholera, especially in rainy season, who are drinking tap waters they are not taking hygienic food, and cause of what? Cholera. Motion, fever and weakness, continuous loose motion, headache, and lot of symptoms is there, cholera. The cholera is also cause of what? Bacteria. The bacteria name is Vibrio cholerae. What is that one? That is the bacteria name. That bacteria is cause of cholera. Cholera is also cause of bacteria, water. Water means what? Not
pure water. Whatever food or contaminated water we are taking, tap water or anything, without boiling, it is cause of what? Cholera. And food, spoiled food. And personal hygiene. You need to wash your hands. Sanitation. Nowadays everybody knows about that one. Sanitation. And boiling, drink boiled water. That is also very important. Why we need to boil the water? That is, nowadays everybody is taking warm water. Why they are taking warm water means what? In that warm water, whatever microorganisms is there in that water, everything is killed. When we are heating, the microorganism, whatever is there in that, everything is killed. That's why boiling of water also very important. And cooked food, warm food. Cooked food also very important. Somebody, yeah, why? Because they given this preventing measure, cooked food. Somebody eating what? Raw flesh. Tinea solium, some type of what? Parasites are also having in that flesh. Without cooking, they are eating some vegetables, some flesh. That is also very dangerous. That's why need to cook. Need to boil the water. This is very, very important. You need to take warm food. Okay, that is very important. Okay, and vaccination is the common thing. Okay, and the hepatitis B. What is hepatitis B? Generally, hepatitis B is also one type of disease. Who are suffered with the hepatitis B? Their eyes, body color, and even urine and everything, it will becomes in a yellow color. Hepatitis B, other name we can call jaundice. What we call jaundice? Actually, hepatitis B cause of what? Virus, contaminated water. Okay, what is preventing measures? Boiled drinking water. Boiled, after that one you have to drink boiled water only, and not only what, and use spray especially for vaccination. Okay, next one we have to discuss about what? Malaria. Okay, malaria is also very dangerous disease, especially who are suffered with what? Malaria. The symptoms also very dangerous, whatever had a chill, fever and everything. Malaria, generally everybody thought that the cause of malaria is what? Female Anopheles mosquito. No, actually female Anopheles mosquito is a vector. What is the meaning of vector? Carrier. What is the meaning of carrier? It carries. Who carries? Mosquito. Which mosquito? Female Anopheles. What it carries? Disease causing microorganism from infected person to healthy person. That means vector, one more word, carrier and vector. Some insects are carrying disease causing. For example, this person is infected person. Okay, we have right here, infected person. Mosquito, this is what? Mosquito. Okay, whatever I am drawing. Okay, mosquito. When the mosquito bites infected person, that carry infection to infected person to healthy person. Later, healthy, after incubation period, healthy person is also suffered with what? Malaria. That means some insects also cause of transmit the diseases. Here the example is what? Mosquito. Which mosquito? Female Anopheles mosquito. This female Anopheles mosquito carries what? It carries malaria disease from infected person to healthy person. Generally, malaria, the cause of the pathogen of malaria, disease causing microorganism of malaria is Plasmodium. Try to remember the name. Plasmodium. What is Plasmodium? Disease causing microorganism. Who is female Anopheles mosquito? Just a vector. What is vector? It transmits the diseases from infected person to healthy person. Just a vector, mediator. Okay. Anyway, okay, what we have to do to preventing measures of malaria? Generally, everybody's home, we are using what? Repellents. What? All out, good night. and even in some type of agarbattis we are using. And and one important thing, need to keep clean in our surroundings. That is very important. Stagnant water, the mosquitoes are laying their eggs in where they're having stagnant water, storing water, storage of water. So that we have to pour few drops of kerosene or petrol in that. The kerosene and petrol kills whatever microorganism, whatever garments. Nothing but garments means what we call eggs of the mosquitoes. Okay, it kills eggs of the maggots, kills eggs of the mosquitoes. So that we have to use some type of DDT and kerosene, petrol, some type of sprayers. Nowadays heat, some type of sprayers also available. And not only that one, and Gambusia. Okay, this is a important thing. Gambusia. What is Gambusia? Gambusia is the fish. These fishes are very small fishes. These Gambusia is the fishes which are useful to eat mosquitoes, maggots, mosquitoes, eggs. Try to understand. So that these Gambusia, what is Gambusia? Gambusia is the fish name. These fishes are useful to eat what? Whatever mosquitoes are living, mosquito eggs are having, these are feeding that mosquito's eggs. So that somebody rearing what? Gambusia fishes also. Okay? Using mosquito nets also. Around our bed, they are covered with what? Mosquito nets, repellents, coils, sprayers, some type of what? Kerosene, petrol, little DDT. So many preventing measures we have to use to kill mosquitoes. Okay, mosquitoes are not only cause of what, especially for malaria, dengue, chikungunya, so many diseases. Okay, so that is also very dangerous. Preventing measures, whatever we learned. Okay, now we are going to discuss, and anthrax also, one more disease is there, anthrax. Actually, it is a bacteria, very dangerous disease, anthrax, especially for cattle. First, it is infected the cattle, it transmits through with cattle. Who are eating what? Okay, especially flesh, raw flesh, also suffered with what anthrax disease. Okay, this is anthrax disease, the cattle disease. The first, it is infect the cattle and also later human beings also. Okay, and now we are going to discuss about some of the common plant diseases. Some of the common plant diseases. Even plants also suffered with what? Microorganisms, or not only plants, all organisms. Okay, now we are going to discuss some of the common diseases, plant diseases. What are they? Okay, here citrus canker. The plant disease name is citrus canker. It affects what? Citrus fruits family, like lemon, orange, whatever is the citrus family. It affects the citrus family. The cause of bacteria. This is causing microorganism is bacteria. How mode of transmission? Air. And the rust of wheat. Okay, rust of wheat. Wheat, generally wheat. Wheat is wheat. This is one type of wheat disease. Is what? Rust of wheat. That cause of fungus. Fungus is the cause of what? Rust of wheat. Okay. And cause of what? How it is mode of transmission? How it transmits the disease means what? Through with insects and seeds. And yellow vein mosaic of bindi or okra. Lady's finger also suffered with what? Some disease. The disease name is yellow vein mosaic of bindi. Okay, generally, okay, mosaic means what? For example, leaf of what? Bindi or okra. Actually, okay, mosaic means what? Like these lines are visible on leaf, surface of the leaf. Okay, the twisting lines are visible, like. Okay, that is mosaic, especially vein mosaics of bindi. Okay, this is cause of what? Virus and insects. Insects are the mode of transmission for the insects. How we will prevent these diseases even in plant diseases? That is very important. There are plant, especially for who are doing agriculture, farmers are using various types of what insecticides. Insecticides are useful to kill insects. Weedicides. Weedicides are useful to kill weed plants. Some sprayers, some chemicals, various types of chemicals. Chemical fertilizers they are using to kill microorganisms which are infected the plants. Okay, these are the some of the examples of how microorganisms are affects human beings and other organisms like plants.